Hey, vinyl community, subscribers, vinyl enthusiasts, welcome back to the Zep Pearl channel. It's me, VK, your host. And first of all, I'd like to thank YouTube for shutting down the video editor that they had on there for like the last 10 years. And kind of just screwed up my channel, so I can't do titles and incorporate edits or anything. So until I find an editor that I can do that with, we're going straight into it. All kinds of stuff to show to you guys since the last time I did a video, and actually stuff I got before that. A lot of metal. I came across a great metal score of some 80s, you know, stuff I didn't have and stuff I didn't think I'd find just because, you know, it just doesn't show up. And also I want to kick it off with some VCLT from the one, the only, thank God, Robert Z. Robert Z sent me a little package a few weeks back, and out of the blue, we weren't really talking about anything. So I want to show you what he sent me, and it's I was very happy to get these. Great items. Let's kick it off with Deep Purple Stormbringer. This is on Electrola EMI on the purple label. This is a pressing from Holland. And, oh, I'm sorry, Germany. This is Germany. German pressing of Deep Purple Stormbringer. Album I didn't have. I should have. One time I passed up a copy that was sealed at Reckless, and I didn't grab it, and I don't know why, but copy of Deep Purple Stormbringer. And anybody that's been following my channel, I've been on this Deep Purple kick and just been coming across stuff, which is great. He also sent me, this one is from Holland. This is Bob Dylan's New Morning, an album I didn't have. This had the inner sleeve with it, featuring other titles from CBS. But a Holland pressing, Bob Dylan's New Morning. Good to hear that. I've never heard that before. One of my favorite Blue Oyster Cult albums, Agents of Fortune. This is a Holland pressing. And let's see, it's on CBS. I'll show you the label on this one. The red CBS label. Now the US version opens up in a gatefold. This is just a single, you know, single sleeve. But still, man, great album to have. And this was kind of the gem of it. I didn't expect this at all. This is a Japanese pressing of the Honey Drippers Volume 1. You know, Robert Z is all into his imports and Japanese pressings. This did have an inner sleeve, which I'd never seen before. Obviously all in Japanese, but on the other side, there's English lyrics plus three pictures of Nile Rodgers, Jimmy Page, and Robert Plant. Now, obviously, Robert Plant was a vocalist, and this was kind of his little side project he did around 1984, which featured Page on a guitar solo for Sea of Love. And Nile Rodgers did, I believe, some producing and probably played on here. Also, I believe, I don't know if some, he had some other players on here. I can't remember exactly. I think Brian Setzer did some work with him on this, too. But what an excellent addition to my... I would have never even thought to seek this out, to be honest with you. The Honey Drippers, Japanese pressing of Volume 1. Robert Z, man, thank you very much, brother. We talked about these once you sent them, and I greatly appreciate you. And thank you very much. Now I'm trying, you know, try not to make this video too long, but I got a healthy stack of 80s metal that I came across. And... a lot of this stuff, I didn't have a lot of this stuff, and I didn't think I'd ever find a lot of it, too, so I was quite surprised. I probably came in the back end of it. I think, I would imagine there was more to the collection when I came through it at the store, but I'm pretty happy with what I found. Let's kick it off with some Seattle guys. Queensryche, Rage for Order. So they're, I believe, 85, 86 album, featured... Gonna Get Close to You is kind of the big radio play video that came off of this album. The one thing, this is the there was a like a limited run, or maybe for, I don't even know exactly if it was limited or first runs or what, but this kind of a blue marble-ish print on the logo there was limited, and there's two versions of it. There's a regular, just a darker version, and then this blue marble. So I was cool to grab this. Always liked that band, you know. At that time, maybe that was like, you know, early progressive metal, you know, what have you, stuff. This, you know, I never had this record. I never bought it. I lost my interest in this band probably around the time Ace left, and that's Kiss. This was Lick It Up, the first album with them. You know, basically really sticking to taking off their makeup. This is a pressing from the Netherlands. See that down there? On the Netherlands there. So, you know, and the price was right. I had to pick it up. It came with an insert here. I had a little test of time there, a little yellowness to it. But nonetheless, to find these in the records are pretty unique. And let's see, this is on Casablanca. We all know the Casablanca label. So I didn't have this album. I knew the hit songs. I never really listened to all the other stuff in there. So it was good to add this to the collection. I don't have a lot of Kiss from the makeup years, or non-makeup years rather. So it was good to add that to the collection. This one was an album I do have. I do have the original U.S. pressing, first pressing of this. But I couldn't pass this up. This is the Michael Schenker Group, MSG album, his first album forming his own band, MSG. This is a Japanese pressing. You got the OB strip going on there. With an alternate cover. I've seen this cover later. I mean, the first cover has the iconic, you know, the logo and the flying Schenker's black and white flying V guitar. But I haven't seen something with this cover, and it came with an inner sleeve, as well as the insert here with, again, it's all in Japanese and track listings, but I'm going to pass this up, man. I had to grab it. Great album. I mean, the first side just kills it. Always a favorite, man. Michael Schenker Group, MSG. All right, here's a couple albums that I didn't have from this band either, man. Getting into these guys a little late, but they've always been around. I mean, I knew some of their major songs, but to actually pick up some of their stuff is great. This is Accept, Metal Heart. This was put out, 86, I believe, or 85. It had the inner sleeve with it. Metal Heart's Accept. Right behind that was the classic that, you know, I know and many of us know is Accept's Balls to the Wall. So I was super stoked to get a nice, clean, pretty decent copy of this. Considering it was black, very little ring wear, if any. Had the original inner in there. And this is on Portrait. This was how it was, man. It was just another kick-ass record after the other one. Now, this one, I'm not too familiar on the rarity of it. I mean, I've been around, but from what I know, this cover was banned in England. That's Iron Maiden's 4-track for Sanctuary. And one reason it was banned, it was because it was Eddie kind of hacking away at Margaret Thatcher there. So, from my understanding, this cover was banned or changed later on, but this was Iron Maiden's. It's a four track, it's two studios and a live track on there on EMI. And I believe this obviously is a let me see here. I had it down too. Doesn't say exactly. I want to say it's a German pressing. I could be wrong. No, I'm sorry, this is Holland, man. Holland's like the country of the video this year. So this is from Holland. Iron Maiden, 4-track for Sanctuary. Here's another album that I have a couple of his stuff, but never had this one. And I had a buddy in high school that was a big fan as well. Yngwie J. Malmsteen's Rising Force. For whatever reason, I didn't have this. Probably out buying more Zeppelin bootlegs or something. This is on Polydor. Strong album. I mean, you know, guitar virtuoso. You know, what can you say about Yngwie? He doesn't get the credit that he should. The guy's still out there playing. I know he came through town. Unfortunately, I missed it, but he came through town not too long ago. And the guy, you know, I've seen some video and footage from it. Man, he still kills it. Man, he's great. Here's another one, man. It's another album that I've been avoiding getting the reissues. I wanted to find originals, but they're really pricey. But lo and behold, man, this one, it was nice priced. Slayer's Reign in Blood. Never had any Slayer on vinyl. Hard to find, you know, originals. There's the original Def Jam inner sleeve. Pretty decent shape. But, you know, the big four, some of the leaders in thrash metal. What can you say? Produced by Rick Rubin. And, what, 1986? So, really happy to get the original pressing of Slayer's Reign in Blood. Now the hunt's on for South of Heaven and some of the other ones. Here's a little trifecta that was in the stash too. Another band that I really, you know, didn't think you'd find too much on. This was Wasp. That's their first album, I believe, from '84. And this is on what's this on? These guys are on Capitol EMI. Got the original inner sleeve in with this as well. Wasp. So that was the first one. Found The Last Command as well. Take this out here. This is right around the PRMC too, man. The lyrics may be considered offensive by some audiences. And they thought this was offensive, really? Yeah, nowadays, come on. So what was cool about this, this still had the original inner sleeve, but also had the order form, you know, that came in a lot of records that a lot of us either ordered and just kind of tossed aside, yours truly, on a few of the Kiss stuff. But came with the order form that was in there, so that was a nice little bonus, kind of an almost complete thing. And like I said, the original inner sleeve, Blackie Lawless and Wasp. And the third one was Inside the Electric Circus. And I believe this did have it too. This had the original inner sleeve as well. So three Wasp albums. I'll tell you, man, this is like one of the first times I've really seen them out there. And I said, these guys are coming home, man. So definitely had to pick those up. We're kind of flying through here. I got a couple more to show. Here's an album. I mean, I wasn't really into these guys a lot. But, you know, you knew of them. You heard the songs on, there was a late night metal radio station here called WVBX, Real Precious Metal. That would play all these bands. Nobody else would touch them here in Chicago because Chicago radio was kind of lame when it came to metal. I might even had a single or something by these guys, but I was looking for this copy. This was the first pressings of To Hell with the Devil, with this cover art of what looks like to be the guys in a band kind of pushing down the devil. And I had this, unfortunately it's on the cover, I don't know if this was just originally on the strength, but it was put on this cover here. Just talking about the album cover and kind of explaining the artwork. I guess they got some heat about the artwork, thinking it was more praising the devil, and they were saying, no, not to hell, you know, they were going to hell with the devil. They were saying to hell with the devil in terms of when you say to hell with you or whatever. But this is the original cover. Later, the cover just came out black, if I remember, with the band logo and the title font there. This is a gatefold too, and you know it's relatively pretty decent, man. It doesn't even fold down; it still holds her bend there. But never had this. Was super glad to see it on with the original cover, and getting into it. You know, it was a Christian kind of metal, and you know it's not that strong though. You know, I mean you would think some of the songs are love songs too, so. Not too bad, not too preachy, but from, you know, Striper, we'll go to Halloween. Keeper of the Seven Keys Part 1. Now here's a band that, I don't, you know, would you consider them, they could have been on the thrash side, maybe not as fast, but then also progressive metal, I don't know, you know, maybe that's a good thing for discussion there in the comments. But Halloween's Keeper of the Keys Part 1. With the original inner sleeve, some cool drawing artwork on this. Let's show this side too, because there is some cool stuff there. another band that I got turned on to from that radio station back in the 80s, man. You'd be surprised on how much stuff they played compared to what's going on now. So that was Halloween, Keeper of the Keys Part 1, and of course right after that was Keeper of the Keys Part 2. Again, man, some cool artwork on this. I'd like to hear what you guys think on this. Here's the inner sleeve on there. Not as elaborate as the other one, first album was. So, you know, this came out in 88. The first one came out in 87. So, it was cool to get this. One of the big songs off this was I Want Out. I remember them playing that a lot. And, to wrap it up, like I said, I just wanted to kind of show you some of the stuff I've picked up, what I'm listening to. The last one I'm going to show, we kicked it off with Deep Purple. I'm going to end it with Deep Purple. This is Deep Purple, Who Do We Think We Are? Japanese pressing. Really, really clean copy of this album. I mean, it's thick cardboard stock here. Let's pull this one out since we're here at the end. Original, inner sleeve, Japanese on the front, got the English lyrics on the back. And this is on the Green Warner Brother label. I'm not exactly sure on the year that this came out on the Japanese press, but with the green label, I'm thinking it's obviously an early 70s press. Maybe my friend Robert Z might be able to give me some idea on the Yobi, if you can tell from that. I had a copy, the American copy of this, a little beat up. So glad to get a nice, just clean copy. Deep Purple, Who Do We Think We Are? Well, that wraps it up, my friends, for another update from the VK Zep Pearl channel. And, we'll get back with you. I do have a lot of other stuff to show, so hopefully I'll do a video in the next few weeks, month, year, who knows. Things have been, chaotic, busy, just time-consuming kind of stuff. And that's it, man. Take care, my friends. Again, thank you, YouTube channel, for screwing up our videos and taking away the video editor. And everybody take care. Peace out.